Hi everyone! Today we're going to look at building a ticket queue decoration in Open RollerCoaster Tycoon 2. If you're going for a more traditional, realistic aesthetic in your park, you may want to add a building where guests can appear to line up and purchase tickets. I want to give a shout out to Caniva's Timeline Park, Canyland, and Dirklink's Park, Mount Dirklink, from where I learned this trick. I've linked both parks in the description below if you'd like to check out some alternative builds. So the way that this trick works is that we're actually going to be building a small ride that the guests will wait in line for, and that will simulate the queues that they'll be waiting in to buy tickets. So since this is an actual ride, it will have to be inside your park boundaries. So most large parks have this sort of entrance plaza with a large open paved area where guests will walk through as they enter. So the quote unquote real entrance to your park will be near the edge of the map here. And maybe you would want to build a fake entrance building somewhere on the other end of the plaza. And we'll have our ticket booth off to the side here. So I'll go ahead and mark out where we want to place that. Let's say we want to have three lines for our ticket booth. And maybe we'll make the building take up this area here. And we'll also have to have a spot for an exit. But of course, since this is a creative scenery piece, you can do this in pretty much any way you want. This is just one example. So for our ride, we're gonna make sure we have a few cheats enabled, show operating modes, unlock operating limits, arbitrary ride type changes, and disable vehicle limits should do it for us. So I'm gonna go ahead and build a ride. I'll be using the wooden wild mouse for this. There are a couple other different rides that work. This one is just, I think, the easiest and simplest to use for this trick, but feel free to get creative with other ride types and see how they operate. And again, I'm going to be using three stations for this, but you can go up to four since that's the current maximum in the game. It's up to you and how you want your ticket booth to be laid out. Oh, we also need clearance checks off so we complete these entrance and exits for now. So what we're going to be doing is moving all the entrances to be lined up next to each other and have the queues in front. But first we need to set the operating mode for our ride here. And I'm going to change it to power launch block section mode, and we'll use a pretty low launch speed for this. If it's too high, we'll get pretty bad lateral g-forces around these curves, and the guests probably won't want to ride it. We'll also put two trains and one car per train. Keep our throughput pretty low so that the lines will remain long. So let's go ahead and give that a test and see how it operates. Alright, next thing we need to do is move all of our entrances so they're aligned with each other. All we're going to need to do is move them one at a time, copy and paste, make usable. I'm going to put them all right next to each other right here. And let's double check that our guests can get on the ride. While that's happening, I'm going to copy and paste the exits as well. They're all going to go on the same tile and make sure they're usable as well. And we'll go ahead and delete the originals. So we're going to wind up with three stations. The entrances are here in a row, and all three of the exits are on the same tile. So the guests will enter the ride from whichever entrance they like, and they'll exit out from the exit. So let's go ahead and add our queues in so guests can line up for the ride. And now all that's left is to do some decoration. First thing I would like to do is hide these queues so that it looks more like just a normal line. I'm gonna copy and paste some footpath here from elsewhere on the map and then hide the queue line. So we just have a plain piece of path here. And I'll do that for the other few pieces. There are a couple different ways you can do this, but this is my preferred method. Next, I'm gonna hide the stations by changing the style to no entrance, just to get those hidden. And I'll go ahead and add some more decoration. I like to also put a fence in between the queues, just so that it's clear where guests need to line up. One other neat trick that I've seen done in a lot of parks is to use the ATM as a window decoration. I don't have it in this workbench, but let's get one included here real quick. And the reason we do this is because the ATM, the front of it just sort of looks like a ticket booth window. So I'll close this, and then what I'll do is use the Tile Inspector to copy and paste this track piece where all three of these entrances are. And I'll delete the original. And then we'll hide this one with walls. The wall arch piece is usually pretty good. And we'll lift that up one tile to make a nice little enclosed window area. And then we'll go ahead and decorate the rest of our building. So this is a very basic example building. Obviously yours is going to look much prettier than this one. But once we get a nice little building around it and we can't see the ride inside, you know, you get the nice illusion that guests are lined up waiting for their tickets. One thing you may notice is that from some angles the top of the ATMs are visible sticking out of the roof, so you know, depending on how tall you make your building, you might want to hide those simply by adding more walls around it. But from other angles, depending on your ceiling situation, they might not be visible, so maybe you don't care. Depends on how you want your building to look. One other thing you can consider doing is changing the ride type of the wooden wild mouse to something like elevator, since if it's a transport ride, in theory, more guests will queue up for it. Again, this is something you can play around with, try different types of rides and see what works best for you. Since all different rides have different throughputs, different operating modes, you'll get slightly different behaviors. So I encourage tweaking and seeing what you can come up with. And there you have it. I hope this video is helpful. If there's something else you'd like to see in the future, let me know in the comments.